Welcome back to Future Perfect. When the Apple iPad was first announced, it was immediately touted as the savior of the publishing industry. Nearly a year after its release, that promise is now being tested with the launch of the world's first iPad-only newspaper. The Daily, a collaboration between Apple and News Corp, is the first tablet-only daily newspaper designed to show off the iPad's potential. Well, the price isn't bad either, costing just 99 U.S. cents a week. Now, the Daily follows Project, a multimedia magazine built especially for the iPad, which was launched by Richard Branson's Virgin Media last November. Some parts of the magazine are available online, but most of its content will be limited to the iPad. It is currently not available for other tablets or the iPhone, but Virgin promises to expand availability in the future. And joining us in the studio to discuss the future of digital publications is Ernie Lopez, the head of ABS-CBN Publishing, which last year launched Metro on the iPad. It was the first local magazine to become available on Apple's tablet device. Thank you very much, Ernie, for coming back to the show.
Thank you, Tony.
Well, it seems like just yesterday, when you were here on the show and we were just starting out, we had you on the show and you did demonstrate to us some of the features of Metro. How has it been doing so far?
We're very happy because since that time we've had we have around six issues of Metro on the iPad right now. They're all still free, but beginning in March we're going to start charging already. But the free issues will stay in the library. You can still
download them for free.
We'll be charging $1.99.
Now, what has the reader's feedback been so far?
Well, everybody I've talked to, you know, who's actually tried it and seen it, is they're very impressed. And I have to say I'm proud of it because the team that's been working behind it, our editorial team and the team that helped put it on the iPad, has been very, very creative. We have a lot of features and functions that even magazines abroad don't have. And these magazines abroad will charge like $5 for theirs. We're still giving ours out for free. But soon we'll have to start charging.
Well, in terms of paving the way for, you know, digital magazines in the Philippines, has anybody else even attempted to do so after you came out with Metro
on
the iPad?
I'm actually surprised that nobody else has jumped into the foray, but
tinitingnan muna nila kung mabubuhay kayo. They don't want to jump in after a sinking ship.
But you know, the longer they wait, the harder it's going to be to catch up. But I really think that the tablets are the future. You know, I mean, when ABS-CBN started, how many years ago? 58 years ago, there were 300 TV sets. If you think about it now, how many tablets are there already? And it's going to proliferate much faster than TV sets, because if you look at the tablet, you know, you can find the Android tablets already for 7,000 pesos.
True.
A TV set is what, 2,500. I'm sure the price of this is going to go down to 5,000 to 2,500, and it's just beginning.
Yeah.
But at a certain point in time, when the economies of scale kick in, you know, this is not just an entertainment device; it's an educational device. All of the TV shows you want to download get downloaded here, the books you want. So eventually this is going to be more widespread than a TV set, because it's more utilitarian than a TV set.
Now, have publishing costs for e-magazines become more affordable, you know, for publishing companies instead of relying on the usual ink and paper format?
Well, you know, the paradox here is I think it's companies that you have to have a deep pocket, because if you're going to go purely digital, it's going to be difficult unless you have a really amazing product.
Because so you have to be Richard Branson.
You have to be Richard Branson. You can throw away money for years, because to be truthful, the advertisers aren't there yet. There's even for our product, you know, I'm still trying to convince the advertiser and show them, hey, look, this is the future. You need to be in there. But they're still, sometimes they're still a little apprehensive and hesitant. And I understand it's because they feel that the number of tablets are not yet big enough for them to take the plunge. But for me, you have to take the plunge now and learn your lessons now.
Sure.
Because this is the best time to learn your lessons, when not too many people are going to see your mistakes.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that the advertisers need to jump in right now, because it's a very exciting time. I mean, if you look at this product, you can put a TV ad on this.
Sure.
But look at the amount of engagement you have. You're about a foot away. A TV set is 10 feet away. This one is there. When a TV ad comes on TV, you didn't ask for it. When you click on a TV ad here, you picked it. You don't change the channel. You watch it to the end.
Mm. And some people actually do enjoy watching TV commercials. I know I'm one of them. Well, at least if they're well made. So even on a tablet, you know, there are place marks there for the commercials themselves. If you want to watch them, then it's up to you if you want to click them. But there is a way, I guess, for you to actually insert the advert before you go to the article.
We are on two different distributors right now. Mm. Our Metro is an app on iTunes, and we can basically do anything there. I mean, you know, we can put video, we can put apps, we can put features, games, we can do anything.
Mm.
The other platform we're on is on Xenio. And we have three magazines there. We have Chris Magazine, Star Studio, and Metro Home.
Mm.
And Metro Home actually is the number one downloaded magazine for us on Xenio.
Mm-hmm. And how much would that cost?
Metro Home, I don't have all the numbers with me now. I know I paid for it. I had to actually pay myself.
It's, okay.
We have a special rate. I think for 6 or 4 issues, you pay a certain price. You
get a discounted price.
Oh. But the exciting thing about it is, even on Xenio, even though it's not on the same platform as the Mac, we can also put video, and we can put a lot of features that behave just like an app.
Right. Well, what kind of other features has ABS-CBN been publishing added to Metro since the first, the initial?
Well, we can look right now. I don't have the Feb issue, but I have the Jan 11 issue.
Okay.
I don't know, where should I
here.
Aim this?
Right there.
There?
Mm-hmm.
Here?
Okay.
Can they see it?
We'll see in a moment.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, who's on the cover?
This is Megan, am I correct? Megan Young, right? I don't know the names of everybody.
Okay.
The guy is some cute model guy. What's his name?
Benjamin Tan.
Benjamin Tan. Sorry, right, Benjamin, I didn't know your name. don't run me over with your car.
Okay.
So if we look inside, we have the body issue. So we can go to Mark Nelson.
Oh, so you actually tapped on Mark Nelson's abs.
That's the only time I'll touch his abs, okay?
Yes, you touched his abs and you went to the article on, yeah, there you go.
So we go this
on
way.
On the models. Yeah.
So we have Lovey Poe. We can press this. And it'll give us some additional information about it.
Okay.
We can go to the next guy. And, you know, like, it'll say here who photographed it, the makeup. So it's a different experience, because the paper doesn't matter anymore.
Yeah.
The colors are sharp. It's the clarity is very good. Let's see if we can turn it this
way. I can tell by that picture that the clarity is very good. Whichever way you orient your iPad. There you go.
Oh, see, Tuesday.
Tuesday, wow.
Ayos ba?
Tuesday works in a body issue.
In the body issue.
So the initial issue that came out retains basically the same features all throughout the other 5 issues that came after.
There are several other. I mean, every issue has new things.
Mm-hmm.
Has new things in it. It's actually more fun to just. To get right into it, let me.
Oh, you just tapped into Mark Nelson's.
Mark Nelson again. I did it again. Sorry.
Yeah, but you tapped lower.
So I can go back to the table of contents. Let's see what the what else they have in store here.
All right.
I usually like to look at the beauty section.
There you go. Who wouldn't?
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So we can look up this way. So it says here, get the look.
Get the look.
So if I tap that. Let's tap it again.
Okay. Hold on.
Am I doing something wrong here? Wait.
Right.
I mean, maybe it's this way.
Maybe, oh yeah. Hmm.
Oh, sorry. Oh, okay. I didn't know how it worked. Yeah. There's a tab.
So that actually shows you maybe how intuitive you have to be, you know, in your interface.
It's fun.
People think you just tap it. It turns out you slide it out.
And so this is how you get the look of that
combination of cosmetics.
This is the makeup
that you need to look like the sexy
model. So let's see. So Tony can look like this if he just puts this stuff on.
I don't think so.
So let's see here. All let's see what it says to get the look.
There you go.
There's all the other makeup again.
So that's fantastic because the advertisers can embed their products into the article.
You know, like if we look at this, we look at this particular workout. So we want to know more about her outfit. I can tap on this is the outfit. Kurt. This is how much. Yeah. This is the brand. We can go back. We can tap on the bangles.
That's pretty
so
cool.
What I try to tell our advertisers and our readers is, you know, when a reader gets in here, there's full engagement.
Exactly.
You know, they're not just reading an article, they're interacting with the product.
Because in the traditional magazine format, you'd have the photo of the model, and you'll probably have lines, numbered lines, telling you maybe the blouse one, the shoes would be two, and then you'd have to go to the legend table to see what, you know, what identification this made. But instead of that, you know, it gives you more information when you just tap on a particular icon.
And it's fun.
Icon, yeah.
It's fun. You know, people just have fun with this. So,
you know, how many other publishing companies are there now locally? I mean, aside from maybe
There's a few that you know that are big. Yeah. There's a lot of small ones. I won't mention the others.
You won't mention?
No, I won't.
I'll mention them first. We'll have to mention them somehow.
We do? No, you don't.
The show's not even half done yet. We will mention them. So, you know, when you think about it, is there like a consensus now among local publishing companies as to whether or not the future of digital publication can be sustained? Or are you going on by yourself?
You know, I haven't really talked to my counterparts lately, but everybody's watching each other. Everybody's looking at each other. I've decided to go on the iPad because I said, I personally, when I go usually to a website, I can't. We've been on the internet since what 1980? Well, 1996?
Thereabouts. Yeah.
You know, we've been on the internet. I can count on my right hand how many times I've clicked on a banner ad.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
You know, how many guys click on a banner ad? But what I notice here is when you see an ad on an iPad, people want, what is it going to do? Mm-hmm. So people tap on it, they get engaged in it. And I feel there's much more value for the advertiser, the advertising potential of this product.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's just, you know, some advertisers just don't have the product yet, so they can't.
They can't demonstrate.
They can't relate. You know, they don't know yet. But every time I sit down with any advertiser, I say, check this out. Yeah. Look at what you can do. They go, oh. Mm. And they understand. So now it's just a matter of the numbers, getting a return for their investment. But so we try to manage our rates so that it's worthwhile.
Yeah, but you'd like to see them go, oh, and then reach for their checkbook, right?
Yes.
Is that like, oh, okay, see you later?
I've seen a lot of people spend money on websites and just not see anything come back.
No
hardly,
returns.
Hardly. I mean, it's so difficult to monetize on a website. But with the iPad, I mean, I think from our third issue onwards, we were already breaking even.
Mm.
So for me, it was really basically a no-brainer.
Yeah. So the paid issues will begin by
March.
All right. Any idea? What's going to be?